Good evening. Hello, Sanbonani. I'd like to say welcome to the third edition of The Scoop, right here on SABC3, where the stage is yours, 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 and all of us. Welcome to the show, guys. Thank you so much for your interaction. We asked you a question last week. If Zoe Saldana had to be dressed by a South African designer, who should it be? Twitter went up in a buzz. And Queen Khanyi, your tweet was the best one because, yes, Gert Johan Kutsia was the popular and people's choice for this question. And I'd like to say thank you to Miss Fudge _M for showing us love and saying you love the attitude, the energy, the effervescence that we bring in the show. Look, we love gossip, we love celebrities and what they do. Ladies, you might not like this, but someone has written songs to talk about how we've made them feel. It could not be you in particular, but the race as women. So stick around because that is the biggest scoop for today. Who launched their album, I Want to Know, hashtag The Scoop, on social media. If you know this, I will give you a shout out next week. Let's get on to the show. So Mzimhlongo Mhlongo, or Kingslayer himself. As we all know, he's got such an inspiring story. Everything he touches turns into platinum. And trust what? His book touched the shelves at Exclusive Books and it's flying off the shelves. Left, right, and center, it is sold out, baby. You need to wait for the second print. I don't know when that will be. So Mzimhlongo, do you have budget? We need the book, do you understand? I haven't had a copy for my mother, is that all right? But nonetheless, it's not about me, it is about you. Hundreds and hundreds of his fans came out to Rosebank to see, hear, and hear him talk about his book and possibly get it signed. So our team went down to see what he had to say and how many fans felt great about this book.
The biggest thing that your book, I think, does is it inspires. And what an honor that so many of you, just by reading Dominoes, are gonna get the feeling I've experienced for 15 years of being a friend with Somizi. You're gonna feel that hope. You're gonna feel like, you know what, I may be 38 today, but my breakthrough is on the way.
It's true that your thoughts, they produce some fluids as a positive and something, And that's how I view it. I never actually believed anything that was said about me. When they said I'm broke, I'm like, broke and 11 rand. When you see the evidence, and I'm the evidence, I mean, in the book I speak about having been told if I've got 2 days to live, having been told I will never work again, having been told I'm down and out.
Losing friends.
Yeah, and losing friends and stuff. So I had to wait for this moment because that happened and this is happening.
So Mzimhlongo, it must be nice being a superstar, isn't it? But another thing that I love, besides my shoes and my clothes and my hair and great food, right, is a man that's got a great body, great abs, round shoulders, chiseled in the right areas, you know, strong grips and just, okay, let me stop right there because I'm losing it. Oof, I'm talking about the hottest man in Hollywood, Idris Elba. He's chocolate. He's built in the right places. But gentlemen, gentlemen, I know we all work out, right? You go to the gym, but there's something you forget. This part of your body can be fit, right? But your legs need to be equally as fit. I'm not trying to date or look at a Johnny Bravo. That's for my daughter. That's a cartoon character, and nobody wants to date a cartoon character. So make sure that everything is equal, like Idris Elba.
Idris Elba is one of the hottest men in Hollywood right now, and even at the age of 44 maintains an impressive physique. In a recent interview, he opened up about his fitness regime and offered some tips to help other men follow in his ripped footsteps. First of all, the actor is sure to start every day with a healthy breakfast, including both carbs and protein. He's particularly partial to cereal and eggs. Second, Idris makes sure not to let his weight vary more than a few kilos. He notes that it's a little harder to do now that he's getting older, but maintaining his workout plan is key and being sure to fit in some exercise every day. And Elba's last tip is not to give up on sports. He credits his athletic childhood for instilling a lifelong love of fitness, playing basketball, soccer, and rugby. For the last 6 years, his sport of choice has been kickboxing, though he says he can't always do it when he's making a movie. As film producers get nervous, he might injure himself and delay filming.
Did you know know that Idris is 44 years old, meaning age is nothing but a number, so you can't use it. I'm too old to look fit, Khanyi. I work too much to look fit. I run companies, I don't have time. My kids, my wife, that is all an excuse because you have the same 24 hours that Idris Elba does. Yeah. I'd like to say happy birthday to Ricky Rick. I saw, brother, you laid out a long two tables with petals, with your family, friends. I thought I was your friend, but I was not there. It's okay, maybe you just didn't want it that way. You were dressed to the nines in a label that starts with G because you are King Cotton. But a man would like to say happy birthday in this moment right now, wherever he is probably filled with cream and cakes and candles and everyone's singing, is Mr. Dalez. Lifestyle, you're my lifestyle, you're my lifestyle. Please hashtag The Scoop, would like to know how you're celebrating. You're probably dressed in your hip hop gear with a red cup in your hand and your squad around you, right? He is having a birthday on Friday and hopefully The Scoop is invited so we could see how you party, how you dress, who your friends are, what you're gonna eat. Did you have a chef? Did you get it catered? Did you have balloons? That is the question. Is Khanyi on the list? I wanna know. Hashtag happy birthday, Liz.
Ricky Rick went all out for his milestone 30th birthday with lavish decor, personalized plates, and a menu inspired by the rapper's chart-topping titles. Maps Maponyani shared pics on Twitter, where he described the party as lit AF. Celebrity chef Lester Chef Lesego Seminya created a dazzling masterpiece for the big event where Ricky got to have his cake and eat it. Now moving on from one Les to another, after 10 years in the game, rapper Dalez is preparing to celebrate his 31st birthday this Friday. Perfect for a winter night, the theme is furs and velour.
Let's go overseas to another man who is 55-0, Mr. Vin Diesel.
On the 18th of July, Vin Diesel celebrates his birthday. Vin grew up in New York City. At age 7, he and his twin brother and some friends broke into a theater to vandalize it, but were confronted by the artistic director who offered them parts in the show rather than calling the police. The athletic star has since risen from being a young vandal to become one of the most in-demand actors in Hollywood, especially in action movies. His films, including The Riddick, XXX, and Fast and Furious series, have grossed over $5 billion. Diesel will likely be celebrating with his partner, Mexican model Paloma Jimenez, and their three children, son Vincent, daughter Hania, and youngest daughter Pauline, who's named in honor of his late friend and Fast and Furious franchise co-star, Paul Walker. Happy birthday, Vin!
I love when love wins, and it always does. People that are spooning, but they've made it forever, they're about to take vows and take it to church and bring families together and bring lots of other tiny little teaspoons. We'd like to say congratulations to Bonhle Modisele for her beautiful engagement. We saw pictures and thank you, girl, for sharing it on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook of your big, beautiful day. But the question is, did you know? Did you know that he was, or did you just act like you didn't know? Or did you see signs? Okay, like that, I always wanna know, but congratulations, you're getting married. Okay, back to work. So how would you feel if you dated a man and later on you hear that he's about to write a song about you? I mean, it's enough breaking up with someone and the pictures and the history they know and the funny toe that you have that you always hide with closed shoes. That is too much. How would you feel? Well, that scoop is about to come later on in the show. Bring your spoon. But before that, go to the kitchen and wash it over the ad break. I'll be here waiting for you. Go. Welcome back, and thank you so much for cleaning your spoons in the kitchen and listening to me. Neo Rojoto on Twitter, thank you so much for your tweet that the show gives you the va-va-voom. Well, you give me the va-va-voom because you keep me alive. To all the comedy lovers, this is a film that you're definitely going to love. But The Scoop does have a PG-13, but you need to see it to understand. Don't say I didn't warn you.
Dev Patel and Ben Stiller are in talks to star in a new movie about the rise of all-male nude revue, The Chippendales. Lion star Patel is close to signing on to play Steve Banerjee, the Indian immigrant who created the male dance troupe, while Stiller is reportedly on board to portray Nick DeNoia, an Emmy-winning producer who helped Banerjee recruit his hunks. The project has been called a True Life Boogie Night as Banerjee transformed a Californian club into an adult entertainment wonderland with female mud wrestling bouts and a females-only male exotic dance night. As the club prospered, Banerjee and Denoyer fell out and the latter was murdered. Banerjee then pleaded guilty to orchestrating the hit and confessed to hiring a hitman to kill other rivals. He hanged himself in his jail cell hours before he was to be sentenced to a lengthy prison stint in 1994. His death was ruled a suicide. The Chippendales movie has been a long time coming in Hollywood circles as Oliver Stone, Tony Scott, Barry Sonnenfeld and David Michaud have reportedly all been attached to direct. Stiller and his fellow producers have yet to name a director for the current film.
Yep, that's why I had to warn you. But moving on from underwear to underdogs, in case you missed the hilarious trailer, there's a new local comedy that's hitting cinemas this weekend. Forget the old jokes and open up yourself to the fresh and the new, right? So take the van, the myth, and the legend. The film does include a love story, which is what we love. Check it out. Van der Merwe.
Call me Van.
Farmer Van, at your service.
Morning, Pop Top.
Hello, Pa.
Don't call me that. It's never been proved.
How's your Vanky?
My favorite little brother.
And your big brother.
Oh, but still so small, huh?
Boys, what?
What happens is the beer percolates. Boils and percolates into the chicken.
Why don't I call Suzette? She can come pick you up.
Because she's the one who told me to brother come home.
From its poop hole, through the chicken.
You've had far too much to drink. I'm going to call you again.
Sure. Just don't call me a poop hole.
What is it?
It's Marika. She's engaged.
Oh, sure, so awesome. I'm so happy for you.
To who?
George.
Sounds like an Englishman.
Yeah, from England.
I am Delandrai. I'll be your wedding planner.
I'm Van. I'll be the man unable to pay for it.
Marika tells me you're studying to become a doctor.
That's right. I'm in my fifth year now.
Shame.
Slow learner.
That's all right, mate. I got it covered.
You're trying to make me look stupid in front of Durandrai.
No, Delandrai.
Denandrai.
No, Delandrai.
Delandrai, it's Spanish.
No Van der Merwe will ever marry a bomb. Not while I'm alive.
I love you so much. I don't know if I'd ever be able to live without you.
Is that you or the beer talking?
It's me. Talking to the beer.
He's choking.
Help, help, somebody, please just do something, please.
After him out. Or a vet even.
What? What you doing?
Doc said I should watch what I'm drinking.
If life was only just as good as that movie. But it's bad when people take the movies, the violent parts, and take it into real life. Like what happened at Calm, right? With Faith Queen Twerk? How do two women, even if it's jealousy and alcohol, stab each other? What are we trying to say? I mean, it's enough that women have been killed. It's enough that women are kidnapped. It's enough that women are fearing for their lives. But when women now jump on each other, because of jealousy, because there is no explanation what happened to her. I mean, even if she's on Twitter and Instagram telling us how great her life is, it is social media. Even if she had to walk up to you and tell you how great she is, just celebrate her. I hope she's recovering because the face is the reception to any of our rooms. Wishing her luck, but women, girls, if you don't like someone, just leave. Go to the next club. Joburg has enough clubs to service us all. And I'm sorry to Faith. I hope you're healing. Call me, I've got good doctors. So Mr. Nyovest, as we all know, went to Ibiza to have fun with the water with Miss Thando Tabete, and they did party up a storm and mingled with stars and rubbed shoulders with the rich and famous. But now Twitter was in a rage, feeling that Casper Nyovest is the king of swag at the moment, running the hip-hop game currently. How could he just get so starstruck and forget who he is? Forget that he's Nyovest, the best of the best. And he just went crazy when Paris Hilton, the blonde DJ now, heiress of Where You Sleep With Your Bae, Proper Slee, or Holiday Family, that girl, yes, that woman, that star. And he just lost it. Apparently was jumping up and down because she said that he smells good. But I guess South Africans don't understand why, when you're our king, you're supposed to go to the world and shine, baby, because we brag about you and you're one of our own. So Mr. Nyovest, with all your love and everything else, I'd like to give you a wooden spoon. Reason being, you forgot that you are the king. So even if you do smell good, you just look at them and go, I can sell it to you. Because you do have a brand, right? It has to do with Vuyo Dabula. It has Hamilton Dlamini. Big names that you see on television that look like cowboys in dust and looking so, so edible, all of them, even Kenny. I can't wait to see this film, and I know you can't too. Hashtag the scoop. Maybe we could have a girlfriend's night out at the movies with Khanyi. I don't know. I'm just dreaming. I'm just hoping. But I know for a fact that it's been selected at major A-list festivals around the world, but we'll only know because it's only going to be announced next month. But you will hear it first from At The Scoop Africa across our social media. So it's not only on TV, we also have you on the social space. So we'll keep up to par, and we're holding thumbs because it's that great. I'm one to always point out great things that my family does, and SABC3 is my home. So they took some of our family members, cast members from Isidingo, and contestants from Mrs. South Africa to go to the Steve Biko Academic Hospital in Pretoria to visit kids that are being treated for cancer, to talk about sharing, love, and inspiring them. I'd like to say big up to the contestants, the cast members, and SABC3 for doing such a great job.
We're here to support the kids.
If you can give your time, it's very precious and special.
Such as everybody's life in some way or another.
I had a scare last year.
My character suffered from breast cancer on the show on Isidingo, but besides that, it's also quite close to home because my father died of lung cancer in 2001.
I'm really inspired to do more, and I hope that this visit, you know, will inspire other people as well.
A year ago, I lost my dad to cancer. So can you imagine a world without cancer?
It's great to see people putting smiles on other people's faces. So there's a twist this week. Our movie top five, we've changed it around. We call it the movie hit list. So it's basically us looking to your tomorrow and telling you things that are going to be coming on the big screen. Movies to look out for. So that is another scoop. We're giving you things that probably directors are still writing about, that even thought about shooting, but we have it right now. Check it out.
You would have been an orphan girl on a stormy sea. Marriage is a safe harbor. Love, honor, and obey.
Amen.
Amen.
I've come to paint a portrait.
They'll say, look there at that lucky old dog. Didn't he have a lovely young wife?
What are you looking at?
What am I looking at?
That painter. I don't want him back.
I'll tell your husband what you've been up to.
What did you say?
First to flower, first to fall.
Come away with me.
Your proposition is absurd.
Sophia!
Mr. Prater tells me you've been busy. He doesn't mean painting.
There you go. She's all ready, Captain.
Thanks, Billy.
People die or disappear 6 times the national average. And that's just grown-ups. Kids are worse.
Look, it's all connected by the sewers. That's where it lives. What happened?
Bill?
Oh my. What is that?
come with me, you'll float too.
George.
You'll float too. You'll float too. You'll float too. You'll float too!
Will you marry me?
What happened?
Katrina!
Wait!
You gave up everything after that, didn't you, Mitch?
No, not everything.
What'd you think?
You were gonna kill Mansour and wipe out his whole cell.
For starters, yeah.
I know exactly what to do with you.
Some bad things happened to you. Now you want to kill those mean old terrorists.
You think that qualifies you for my selection process?
My guess is if you and I go hand to hand, you can probably figure out inside of 20 seconds whether or not I have what it takes to make it through your selection process. So, what do you say?
What is it you think we do here?
We kill people who need to be killed.
He's ready, Stan.
He's not ready. He will be.
This wasn't a malfunction. It was intentional.
There's potential for catastrophic weather events on a global scale.
A geostorm.
We have to shut the system down.
The only one who has the kill codes is the president.
I need your help.
You're soliciting a Secret Service agent. Seriously? We're kidnapping the president in a self-driving cab.
Jake, if you can't stop it, no one can.
3, 2, 1. Come on, baby.
You realize you're committing treason?
Oh, yeah, I kidnapped the president. I've stolen state secrets. Yeah, anything I'm forgetting, honey?
Honey.
Hold on!
I've been hinting throughout the whole show about a big scoop that I'm going to share with you with a hip-hop artist that launched his album and great song that we all know is called Celebrity. I've seen on social media people have been saying it's Reason. Those of you that said Reason, well done, you are right. Our team found themselves at Tubu in Sandton to celebrate the launch of his album.
It's just a story that captures 14 experiences that were had between me and many other women. Well, not that many. Let me not make myself sound so trash, as trash as I am. But yeah, it's about 7 people that actually gave me experiences that were able to create this story. And it's called Love Girls.
If a woman had to come across and say she's writing an album about her exes as males, wouldn't society jump up and go, ha! Huh? Oh my gosh, no ways. You had a boyfriend for each day of the week and you're still standing? How? Is it right for men to come out and say, listen, I've had 7 girlfriends and this is what they did, and then we say, well done, yeah. So my question is it all right for rappers, book artists, movie writers to write movies, songs, and things about their exes? And how does Loot Love feel? Yep, I know, we're all shaking our heads, rubbing our heads, yeah, but I'd like to say to my boyfriend, if you ever wrote an album like that, you wouldn't make it to the stage or the video shoot. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. Thank you so much for joining us this week on The Scoop. We love you so much. Let's take the spoons and put them back in the drawer, because we're going to need it. SABC3, the stage is yours, so this is where you belong. See you soon.